Chew? What? You want me to chew? No problem. I mean, after all, I have molars. I can masticate with the best of them. Oh, I get it. Chew. You're sneezing. Humans do it all. Sneeze, chew. You know who can only do one of those things? Snakes. And if you guess that the thing snakes can't do is sneeze, sorry. They can't chew, but snakes can sneeze. Yes, beware the sneezing snake. Even though they don't seem to have noses, snakes do have nostrils. However, they only use their nostrils for breathing. Snakes do their smelling with their tongue and a thing called the Jacobson's organ, which is located above their mouth, kind of between the nostril and the eye. The snake picks up hints of whatever there is to be smelled on its tongue and then passes them back to the Jacobson's organ for decoding. To give you an idea of how well this thing works, consider how different nature's best smellers, dogs, are from snakes. Canines are friendly, furry, and warm-blooded. Serpents? Not so much. But these two do share the Jacobson's organ. Sneezing is another thing both dogs and snakes do, and we'll get to snake sneezes soon. But for now, I hope you never find a snake in your boots. Unlike a dog, the snake won't chew up your shoes. Because while snakes can bite, they don't have molars, so they don't chew. Instead, snakes swallow their prey whole, even when the thing they're eating is bigger than their mouths. How do they even fit it in? Well, instead of bringing their top and bottom teeth together to grind their prey up into little pieces, snakes unhinge their jaws and bring their teeth apart. The jaw remains connected by muscle and tissue, but once unhinged, it can open as wide as 150 degrees. That's almost a flat line. Snakes wiggle their unhinged jaw all around and under their prey. If that won't work, they twist and flip their heads over, then wiggle the loose jaw over the top of their prey. Naturally, the meal tries to object because, well, it doesn't fancy being this snake's dinner. But the snake is prepared. It uses its fangs not to chew the prey, but to inject it with a venom that either numbs the critter or has a calming effect, allowing it to go down easy. Once our snake swallows whatever its unlucky dinner is, it typically takes about 4 days to digest it. If you happen to visit with a snake during this time, you'll notice an obvious lump in its otherwise tube-like body. But don't tell him he's looking a little rounder in the midsection. You might hurt his feelings. Maybe you've wondered why, with something so big in their mouths and throats, snakes don't choke. You know as well as I do that you can't breathe and swallow at the same time, right? Otherwise, your macaroni just went down the wrong tube, and you go into a watery-eyed fit of coughing. Well, snakes have evolved with a perfect solution to this dilemma. They have an opening in the bottom of their mouth, right behind their tongue, called a glottis. When necessary, or for a rad party trick, the snake can push its trachea, that's its windpipe, out through the glottis and breathe through it like a snorkel. This way, it can still breathe while its prey obstructs its mouth. Talk about multitasking. But can the snake dance while it does all that? Maybe if there's a snake charmer nearby. By the way, how do snakes hear the music and how does it transfix them? Even without rabbit ears or antenna, snakes hear just fine. They have a good inner ear. But they're not responding to the hypnotic rhythm of a snake charmer's song. It's the swing. No, not the popular jazz form, though that's nice. I mean the motion. When the snake charmer weaves back and forth, the snake mistakes his pipe for a fellow serpent, a potentially aggressive one. It responds defensively by mimicking the pipe's movement. Knowing that snakes hear, it's natural to presume that they talk to each other. After all, we often catch them whispering. But remember, it's bad manners to tell secrets, and excellent manners are part of a snake's charm. Unlike a whisper, that famous hiss is meant to be heard. It's a warning, one you should heed. But careful where you put your feet. Make sure that hissing snake isn't protecting a nest. If you accidentally stomp on her eggs, well, you better move fast. Speaking of fast, achoo! Did you know that we sneeze as fast as 100 miles per hour? That means our sneezes travel way faster than the fastest snake, the black mamba, which clocks in at 12 miles per hour. Might not sound that speedy. I mean, it's slow for a car, right? but think of how small snakes are next to people. Then compare the Black Mamba speed to that of Usain Bolt. Widely considered the world's fastest human, Bolt set records by running 27.8 miles per hour, a little over twice the Mamba speed. And the Mamba does it without feet. Snakes are famous for their hypnotic gaze. But snakes don't blink because they don't have eyelids. So how do they protect those mesmerizing peepers? The same way they protect the rest of their body, with scales. These transparent or see-through eyeball scales are called brill. In some ways, brill is even better than an eyelid. It shields and protects the eye while never interfering with sight. Cool. Snakes can climb trees, but they can't climb glaciers because they don't like the cold. Plus, the ice is slippery. And while snakes might cling to warmer climates, I'm sure you know that they do let go of their skin. Salamanders do it too, as well as crabs, lobsters, and scorpions. I've never seen a lobster belt or scorpion shoes, but snakeskin accessories are a thing. Before you wear something made of snakeskin, double-check that the snake is done with it. Then again, if you can get a live snake to hold up your pants, you'd make fashion history. However, even those who want a smaller waist should watch out for the boa constrictors. Incidentally, we humans shed our skin too, just a bit at a time. Human skin is a prime ingredient in house dust and dandruff. Two heads are better than one when conducting research, but not on the same snake. The condition of having two heads is called polycephaly. Though rare, snakes are more prone to it than most animals. And apparently, it's double trouble. Whether food collides in single-throat traffic jams, the body doesn't know which head to follow, or the two can't decide on weekend plans, snakes with polycephaly have trouble in the wild. If you see a two-headed snake, don't think twice before saying hi twice. And if the double-headed serpent sneezes, make that two Gesundheits as well. And if that sneezing double-headed snake is your pet, first of all, whoa, where did you get one of those? Also, it's probably time to take him to the vet. For snakes, sneezing is often a sign of respiratory infection, especially if he sneezes a lot. When else should your snake see a vet? Well, anytime he's acting sluggish or lazy. Behind the brill, a healthy snake will be clear-eyed. Also, his tongue should dart frequently. Yes, absolutely, snakes sneeze. They clear their sinuses and mouths of debris by exhaling rapid, vigorous bursts of air. Some people think it's not a real sneeze because it's not exactly like our sneeze. Sounds a little species-centric to me, and sneeze is the term veterinarians use, so I'm sticking to it.